Hey everyone, this is Deanna Fusillo with the Startup Circle. And today I have with us Amanda Flischer, who is a strengths coach out in San Diego. And we are going to be talking about strength-based startups. Now, I have a really funny story about Amanda. Amanda and I guess it's pretty serendipitous how we met. Of course, you know, I'm all about social media, and I was going through Instagram. Now, I have no idea why her post popped up. I wasn't following her. I don't even know what I was really searching for, but she had a contest going on. And what was really funny about the contest is she was doing a giveaway of the Strength Finders book. Now, my friend Wayla, for, oh my goodness, maybe the past year, had been bugging me to do my Strength Finders test. And I did the test and I put it on my desk, and it was something that I wanted to get back to and look at and to really dig into, but something that I put on the back burner and just really didn't have time to dig into it, but I really, really wanted to. So anyhow, when I saw that somebody was having this contest to win this book, I'm like, oh, this is perfect. So now I can finally dig into what these results mean and figure it out and learn a little bit more about who I am and why I'm wired the way I am. So and let's be honest, like, I've entered some contests before that have been online. I usually don't, because I'm one of those people that just assumes like I'm never going to win, so whatever. But I took a chance. I'm like, what the heck? I've got nothing to lose. I'm bored. I'm just scrolling through Instagram. So I'm just going to go ahead and tag Wayla and enter this contest. Well, I think it was just a couple short days later, and I got a notice from Amanda that I had won. And I was so happy. I think I may have actually like jumped up and down. It was like the best thing in the whole wide world. So when I called her, of course, you know, and we connected, she sent the book, and she called to kind of go over what I'd already done, because I told her I took the Strength Finders test and I told her all about it. And she was like, you know, do you want to go over those results? And I think, honestly, we just talked about everything under the sun that day, didn't we, Amanda?
I think we did, pretty much.
Long story short, built a great relationship with her. Absolutely love her. Have learned so much from her in a short amount of time. So thankful. And I just had to share her gift and everything that she has to offer with all of you. So I have Amanda here. I'm going to give you a little bit of story about her. Welcome, Amanda. I'm so glad you're here.
Oh, I'm so glad to be here. And it is truly serendipitous that we are here together.
It absolutely is. I love it. I love how it all happened. For sure. So I'm going to just tell you a little bit about Amanda. As a self-leadership coach, Amanda has worked with individuals to dig deeper, move past learned beliefs and values, and to uncover their unique value system. She guides them through making better choices, better goals, and ultimately having more satisfaction in their achievements. Amanda holds an associate certified coach certificate through the ICF. It's a trained strengths educator. Boy, that's hard to say. If you say it like that. Yep. Mm-hmm. Through Gallup, and is a college professor. Amanda has over 8 years of experience coaching and training thousands of individuals to learn what it takes to redefine their achievement and take the lead in their own life. She began her private practice in 2014 after several years of working in the leadership development and behavioral health fields. And we are so lucky and so fortunate to have Amanda here with us now. So welcome, Amanda.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. I'm going to turn this over to you, and you can start to talk to us a little bit. There you are.
Here
you
are. Here you
are. Yay. About this strength-based startup. Yeah. So what does it take to a startup? What does it take to start up a business?
Yeah. So first and foremost, thank you again for letting me be on here and talk to your audience. And, you know, all the stuff you're doing around startup is amazing. I think when we talked a lot about what you're up to and what you're doing with your crew and just how hard it is to start up. You and I both know it takes a lot of guts to get out there, right? it takes a lot of courage. It takes a lot of initiation to start up a business. So being, you know, certified with as a strengths educator with Gallup, a trained educator, I love Gallup. I love their work. I love what they do. And so they actually went out and researched a lot about what does it take to be an entrepreneur? And they came up with these five key areas of what it takes to really become an entrepreneur and to really develop in these characteristics. And so, because really what they wanted to look at, and so I have a long history of working with employee engagement and really understanding what do people want from their jobs, what makes them happy, right? You and I know this, like sometimes starting up a business is just out of sheer, I want to get this particular thing started and I just don't know where to go. Right. And my job isn't doing it for me. So, and that's my story. My backstory was I worked in corporate for a long time. I felt a calling to do this work. And so it took years and years and years to really start up and get going. But the seed was planted years before I even launched. And then there was finally this like kick out the door in my head of like, okay, it's time. Right. So an interesting statistic about, you know, just in general, employees in America is that only 13% of employees are actually like happy in their job. That's a really staggering number, right? Like that's really bad. So in that though, there's only about 20% of people that have actually found their job that aligned to their strengths. Now, I'm sure Deanna, you and I can both say like we have created a job that plays to our strengths, right? Like, right? Like I think that's what, you know, for me, I was teaching the other night and my students even said like, man, you have carved out a job that literally just runs down your strengths. So it's true. Once you start to hone these practices and start to do this stuff, you will start to feel these five areas in the startup mode. So here are the five. So I just kind of want to give you the five. And then, you know, and Deanna, if you have any questions, like we can run through these too. But what they found was gut instinct. Those that do really well in startup mode and as being an entrepreneur is that they have this gut instinct constantly. They're always listening to it. They have gotten really good at identifying it and to really understand what that means to take that initiative of listening to your gut. So I'm sure you and I both know we've done that many times, right?
Yes, we have. I just had that conversation today, I think, as a matter of fact, with someone about your gut instinct. Yes.
Yeah. And it is, but you have to hone that skill as well. Right. Mm-hmm. So that's the first one. And then personality characteristics, just what are your unique personality characteristics that make you want to do the job that you're aiming to create? And personality characteristics can be just those little quirky things that we do that make us, you know, and it could be that you, and we'll get into strengths, but these are kind of bigger things outside of us that, you know, maybe you're more of a people person. Maybe you're more of a behind the scenes person. Maybe you like to listen to music versus, you know, have a quiet, you know, those little personality characteristics. And so really paying attention and honing those skills. And then this is a big one. And this is where I do a lot of work. And Deanna, I know we've talked a lot about this, but that self-belief about believing in your ability to do what you're setting out to do, right? Yep. And I would imagine, I don't know for you, but that's a big one, right? In this process of starting up.
Well, absolutely. Yeah. You have to believe in yourself and what you're doing in order to move forward.
Right. And that
there'll be a lot of naysayers around you trying to stop you, right?
Oh my gosh. I have stories just so you know, the day leaving corporate, just the story. So there's it's called self-efficacy and it's the belief in your ability. So, again, it's really honing in on that skill of belief. And then the other two are achievement orientation and then taking risk. So achievement orientation, meaning you are constantly striving to achieve. You're constantly putting goals out there and maybe not even goals. I just got off the phone with an amazing client and she doesn't set goals, but she has this like vision for where she's headed and she just keeps going and going and going. She's like, I feel bad. I never set goals. And I was like, it's okay. Like that's not you, you know? But it is this constant achievement. It's challenging yourself, using what you know, and then continue to keep going. Right. And then risk taking. I mean, starting a business, oh man, you got to risk a lot. So you got to risk, but there's planning in the risk. My coach always jokes with me and says that like, I'm a planned out risk taker, you know, and I am like, I'm very much like, I'll weigh all my pros and cons. I'll be very careful about what risk I'm going to take. Cause I do have a family. I do have kiddos, you know, so everything matters in the risk, right? So, but you have to eventually jump, right? You got to jump a little bit and take a little bit of risk without knowing on the other side what's going to happen. So those are their five characteristics that they found of startup and really those entrepreneurs that stick with it and know. And then there's grit, of course, that we all talk about, but like grit is that idea that like perseverance, we keep going through. So those are, so those are the five that I believe, to start us off with that conversation of what does it take to start up and how do you have that strength in starting up? And so those are kind of where we're aiming at, is to get to hone those, to hone those five.
Now, Amanda, you talk a lot about confidence, and I know that you actually have a whole other workshop that can be just about confidence.
Oh yeah, totally.
And are you getting an echo back?
I am not. Are you?
Okay, good. I am. Yeah. But as long as you're not, that's okay. So you're getting the dog.
Yes, I'm sorry. I knew my dog would bark. I'm sorry. Mailman.
It's fine. Here. It's really fine. So what does confidence look like? Like, how do you hone in those characteristics?
Yeah. So those five are really smart, right? Like it's really those five kind of put together of gut instinct, personality characteristics, self-efficacy, that belief in yourself, and then achievement orientation and risk taking. But you really can't, you got to have the confidence to really get into those five, right? And so what I've kind of narrowed down in my practice is what confidence comes down to is three things. It's your strengths, knowing your values, and knowing what you need or want, basically, for your career or your startup or your life or whatever. And so confidence is this very rooted place that you know exactly who you are and you know exactly what you want and you know exactly where you're heading. And headed meaning I have a path, right? It doesn't necessarily mean I know the outcome. Because we never really know the outcome, unless we
don't,
right? Even us trying to get all this today, right? Like we're like, is it gonna go? Right? Is this
work out? Absolutely true. So, if we're talking about strengths, and you and I are familiar with strengths and strength finders, but can you explain a little bit about what strengths are?
Yeah, for sure. So, in that confidence model, right, of the three things. Strengths, according to Gallup, so I highly recommend you all take StrengthsFinder, right? StrengthsFinder is now our connection. What StrengthsFinder does is, strengths are this idea into your innate talents. It's your innate ability. It's your innate, the natural things you think, feel, and do. Basically, that's it, right? And so sometimes we do things so easily that we don't even realize that they're strengths. Right? They come so naturally to us. We're just like, it's just me. I just know how to do that. Right? But that's a strength and you need to hone that. And so what StrengthsFinder does is that kind of like tells you and really like shines a light on these things that we do well. Because the thing is that we all grow up believing we have to work on what's wrong with us. Right? We have to work on these places of weakness. And that's just not true anymore. There's so much research out there saying you will be so much better if you focus on what's right with you. Manage the weak, manage what you don't like doing, manage what's going on, and manage meaning maybe learn some skills, maybe learn some knowledge, but delegate, right? Like who can you delegate stuff to? Or maybe that's not the right path, and so it's really honing those skills or the strengths of who you are and what you do. And then you aim it at the startup. Right. Mm-hmm. So strengths is, like I said, natural feelings, thinking, behaviors, those natural things. So for me, one of mine is high futuristic. I very much live in the future. I'm constantly thinking about what could be and what's possible. Right. Which is great for my clients because then I can take them there. Right. And so once I kind of found those out, it was like this, like, I don't know if you felt that way.
I did. I definitely did.
Yeah. Because it's one of those things where once you get the aha moment of what you do well, it's kind of like, oh, okay, I don't have to do all these things anymore. Right.
Right.
So, some of them were really funny. I joke with my husband all the time. Like he's always like, you have no empathy. And I was like, you're right. It's actually really low on the thing on the bottom. Right. So We joke all the time. Of course, I have empathy, but it's one of these, it's not one of my strengths. So, but I have high harmony. I have high positivity. Like empathy just shows up very different for me in different ways. But there's some people that are led 100% by empathy in that emotional state. So strengths are, like I said, it's this natural way of thinking, feeling, and behaving. And that is part of the key to then having confidence, which then leads you to these five key areas of how to start up a business, right? And to continue with starting up a business, right?
Right. So if somebody wanted to find out more about these strengths, and you're telling people to take the strength finders, like where would they go, or how do they find out what their strengths are?
Yeah. So they could go, there's two of them. So if you're a student and you happen to be starting up a business and you're part of this, you know, network, you could go to Strengths Quest, and that's focused directly on, so strengthsquest.com, and that's focused directly on college students. But if you are, you know, working already, it's the same test. It's just a matter of if you have a student, ID, you can get, a little bit of a discount on the other one. But if you are, just regular everyday people like us working. It's Strengths, Gallup Strengths Center. I know it's really long. Gallup Strengths, that's plural, center.com. Okay. And the test is $15. Best test you'll ever take in your life, I promise.
I would agree with you. Definitely would agree with you.
Yes.
So once we know what those strengths are, how do we develop them? What do we do with it then?
Yeah. So to develop them, it's okay. So awareness is first key, right? Like just being very aware of what are those five. Then it's please dive into the knowledge, right? Like please dive into all that stuff. It's hiring out a coach or being a part of this, you know, network or circle or someone to really develop those even more. And really looking at where do these strengths show up for me in my life? Where are they showing up for me in my work, my home, my personal life, my friends, my family, like just start to develop them, right? Just, you know, for my futuristic, I was like, yes, this is me, right? And so what does that look like when I hone it? What does it look like when I become, when it becomes really strong?
Yeah.
So, and in that it becomes this like near perfect performance is what they call it. And it, you feel it. I think we've all felt that, right? I'm sure you felt the flow of like, right, something being like, oh my gosh, I want to stay in this space, right? And so that's really what strengths is all about. It's really, you know, I have another client who has high adaptability, and she's very much can adapt to all these certain things. And when she feels structure getting put on her, no good, right? Like just no good, right? So she's learned that about herself. At first she just thought like, oh, I just don't like authority, but it was never that. It was never about that, because she's, you know, going to be the president of a company someday. You know, she's in line for this. Like she's just amazing. Like she's just this incredible woman. And, but she just is like, when she feels the structure, she's like, oh gosh, that, you know, I just don't like authority. But now that she's a name for it, being adaptability, she just needs that freedom, that flow. Right. To be able to make decisions on her own, and she can adapt in the moment, and that's just her, right?
Definitely. So, and can you talk a little bit about even the people that we work with that come in with us? And I know when you and I first talked, and I said that I was strategic and an activator. Those are my two top ones. Yep. And then you and I hit it off so well. Yep. I'm like, we need to do something together. And I remember your comment, your response was like, well, I know it's definitely going to happen because of what your strengths are. And then here we
are.
But yeah, can you explain a little bit about, you know, and maybe some people are still currently working in their positions, or they have a company where they're thinking about bringing somebody on either as an employee or a freelancer or a partner in a business or partnership.
Yeah.
So what are some things to kind of be aware of or to be in regards to these strengths? Like what are some things they should look at?
Yeah.
I'm sure you recommend they both take the strengths finders to see if they're compatible.
Always. Yeah. I mean, so first and foremost, like if you're still thinking about starting up, the first place to start is just what are my strengths? Like what, because the biggest thing I find with entrepreneurs is that, you're trying to do everything, right? As an entrepreneur, you're trying to do everything from the business side of it to the work of the thing you're trying to do to the finances. I mean, you're just trying to be everything. And sometimes that's just not okay. You know, you're just not built for all that. So it is really paying attention to what are my strengths? What skills am I really great at? And how do I partner these two things together? And so before you make the leap, it's really, you don't have to have this all figured out though. Like, I'm not saying like, don't leap until you have it all. You know, I didn't have it all figured out. Oh my gosh. My husband thought I was crazy and I was like, we're leaving, we're doing this thing. Right. So, he's like, okay.
I've done the same thing. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. But that comes back, I think, to those five things, right. To the gut instinct. I had a gut instinct. So did you. You had self-belief in what you could do and what I've always had that in the gut feeling. I was like, I believe enough in what I'm about to do that I will make it work. Right. So when you're sitting there looking at your strengths, it's really getting belief around this is me. And that's the best testament to doing this work is that this is who I am. Right. So, yeah. It's really knowing your strengths. And so taking the test, really kind of honing and getting to know them. And then if you are bringing on someone onto your team, I highly recommend taking the StrengthsFinder test. And you can't use it as an HR, like weeding them out, like, oh, they've got these strengths, I don't want them. Like, then you can't do that. But you can do it as like, okay, where can they fit in? What are their strengths? How can we partner really well? Because, strengths in themselves, the idea of strengths is to be really sharp, to get really sharp in who you are, and then be well-rounded as a team. So bringing on people who maybe are going to fill the gaps of what you can't do. Maybe someone, like for me, I would absolutely love to hire someone who would do all my PowerPoints. I just have no creativity bone whatsoever. So, you know, it's one of those things, right, where it's like, that's a gap, right? It takes me this long to do it when it should take me like this long to do it, right? So it's really finding, you know, who has that gene basically of the creativity, because that's not me, but really the strength and innate abilities to do those things. And so if you are bringing on someone or thinking about bringing on people, yeah, do a team workshop, do a team meeting about it, you know, and then helping people grow into their strengths is a huge key. Cause we just don't do that enough. It was like learning more about ourselves on the job. So,
right. Are there certain strengths that, and I don't know if there is or isn't, but are there some that are more geared towards entrepreneurs that you see a trend of like, oh yes. So like I could tell that you have this strength because this is what you're doing.
Yeah. It's a great question. No. No. It really is. No, that's the great thing about strengths is that there's absolutely no rhyme or reason behind, you know, when you just look at the strengths, like I'm never going to be able to look at someone's top five and be like, oh my gosh, you're gonna be an astronaut. Like, it's not going to be that way. I mean, if you look at my five strengths, they could be applied to being an elementary school teacher. They could be applied to being a director of something, you know, a learning department or something, or, you know, you could take my five and it could be applied to a whole bunch of different jobs. But what I've done, and I'm sorry, I'm using my five as an example, but
no, that's
what I've honed is, you know, my top five are harmony, focus, consistency, futuristic, and includer. And so together, what that looks like is that I'm constantly looking for the balances, checks and balances of someone that's harmony. Futuristic, I'm constantly dreaming about the future. Consistency, fairness, like I'm always treating everyone with fairness. Focus is like more goal oriented, right? So the dream now becomes a goal. that's how it works in my life. And then includer, I'm constantly including people, constantly inviting, including. And so again, those five, those go be plugged in anywhere, right? So, right. So there really is no like, hey, these five, what is the difference is then, like I said, those other characteristics, which is, do you believe in your gut feeling? Do you know your gut feelings? Do you know what your personality traits are? Do you even know what you want to start up on? Right? Like,
right.
You got to believe in what you're starting up, or guess what? It's not going to last. So, you got to believe in that too. And you and I've talked about this too, where we both have tried new things and it doesn't work, or, you know, we just were like, oh, that sounds like a nice, bright, shiny object. And it's like, well, that's not fitting our bucket of strength, you know?
Right.
So,
that's so true.
So yeah, it's, It's so true. Yeah. Does that answer the question, I guess?
Yeah, it definitely does. So, okay. So as a new entrepreneur,
yes,
or somebody thinking about going into a business, and I take the strength finders, uh-huh, and I find out what my strengths are, how do I use those? Like, are there some tips or tricks, mm-hmm, on how to use it to begin my business?
Yeah. So when you're starting up, I highly recommend really writing down, starting first with all the things that you know you can do, right? Like outside of strengths, just the skills, the knowledge, the things that you're bringing to the table, right? So, mm-hmm, really sitting down and writing down the things that you have been educated on and done for the last, you know, and I would even say if you played on a team sport, like what did you learn back then in high school? Like what did you learn in college? Like what did you learn? Like all those things, just write down all those skills and knowledge that you have. Then what you do is partner it with your top five strengths, which would be those things like, oh, I'm really great at communication, or oh, I'm really great at adaptability or futuristic or focus, right? Like it's going to give you that prescription, if you will, of what your top five strengths or natural talents are. And then you put all those together and you start looking at now the job ahead and saying, okay, what is it that I do really well that's going to make this business flourish, right? Like what is it going to be, you know? So if you are, you know, if you're diving into, like for my work with coaching, I love being with people. Like that's just my thing. Relationship strengths are my number, you know, that's the highest for me. And then getting some work done over here, but PowerPoints, no thanks. Right. but it's been looking at it and honing the strengths plus the skills and knowledge to do the startup. And that's where it starts to lead into that confidence in yourself to be like, man, I got this. Because you need it. Because entrepreneurship is a lonely road sometimes, right?
And oh, so, yes, it is.
And so if you just really hone in on what you can do, and you put stock in you and invest in you and do workshops with Dana or do other things outside or go to online meetings and stuff like that, you'll start to develop your strengths even more. And how you start to pay attention to that though is those pings. I always, you know, I call them these pings in your guts and your feeling like inside of you, like those flow states. That's like, I want to do more of this. What is this? Like, when I was in college, for some reason, I really loved problem solving. But with math and with stuff, I didn't really like math, but for some reason finding a solution was great. Well, one of my top 10 restorative is in there, and restorative is problem solving. So it makes sense. Mm-hmm. It's now honed to, I love solving problems for people, right? Like I love being a problem solver in their lives. I love getting to the root of why they're thinking a certain way. And so I used the strength of restorative and like turned it to like the very things I love doing, which is working with people. Does that make sense?
Right. Yeah, definitely. Okay. Does. Okay. It definitely makes sense. So then basically once you know your strengths, it's going to help you,
yeah,
start your business,
yes,
and lead you to be successful.
Totally. Yes. And then that's the other thing is really defining success for yourself, right? Mm-hmm. We have maybe your definition of success, then there's my definition of success. But what we do, and this is just natural, I think, just women thing that we do, is that we compare our success to other women's success, right? Like, oh, well, I don't have what they have. Oh my gosh, so they've been, da, da, da. But what we're seeing is just the tip of the iceberg. You guys have all seen this, like that little tip of the iceberg is like, we see success up here, but all the stuff that's down here below on that iceberg, that the grit, the time, the efforts it's taken to get to that place. So, you know, success, you have to define for yourself. And maybe it's not monetary. You know, for a long time, I thought it was gonna be monetary for me and my family, but it's not. it's really getting down to my values, which was like personal freedom, family time, financial freedom, you know, creating that kind of lifestyle where we can travel. Like my husband's a teacher, you know, so that we can be gone all summer. That's what success to me looked like, you know? And so redefining success at the end of all this is vital to starting up and to having confidence. So
that is awesome. Yay. Awesome. Yeah. You gave a ton of information.
I know. Amanda. I'm so sorry. I'm like overwhelmed. I mean, do you have any questions?
No, no. I think you answered a lot.
Okay.
And if we do get any questions, okay, then I'm going to have you answer them and I can send them off to you. But let me just ask you, like, how can people get in touch with you
Yeah.
Go over their strengths once they take their strength finders.
Yeah. So there's a few ways. If you want to just go to my website, you can go book a session with me. I do free 30-minute sessions to see if you want to work with me, or just to kind of a discovery session. Deanna and I totally went over like 2 hours, but that's okay. I think we just like totally, you know, we talked about so much stuff. We were so excited. So you can book a session with me, or you can, and it's AmandaFlisher.com. So yes, there's an L in there, Flisher. Or you can just email me at coaching@AmandaFlisher.com and just be like, hey, I want to learn more about my strengths. And, we could do that. But Gallup has a ton of information. The thing that I love about what I've done and what I've created is Gallup has given you the tool. And then what we're missing is, I think with all personality assessments, I don't know if you can attest to this too, is that we take it and we're like, well, that was nice. That's good, right? We're just kind of like, well, that was a good to know. But right. We just don't know how to use it in the right way. We don't know how to like capture that and be like, great, now how do I plug this in? So that's my job, is to really help on that back end of like the application, the you know, like I said earlier, is the awareness. I kind of didn't finish the equation. It's really awareness and then claiming them, like claiming strengths as yours, right? Like really identifying these are me. Cause I can't even begin to tell you, people are like, these aren't mine. And I'm sitting there like, yes, they are. Check, check, check. You know, as they're like, you know, using their strengths, explaining why it's not theirs. And so, yeah, so it's a name, claim, aim kind of thing. And that's what they, you know, Gallup has claimed, you know, has taken is, and it's just all personality assessments. It's you name it, you claim it, you develop it, you make it yours, and then you aim it back out. And my job is to partner you with the claim and the aim, right? To like,
yep.
To really own that and to make it part of your life. And like I said, I have a couple clients this week that have just been like, they just talk in strength mode now. They're like, oh, this is my focus, or oh my gosh, this one's like totally in the way. Like even you being like my strategic and activator, like,
yeah. Right? It's true. Yes. And you know what? I was thinking, like, I know, remember the first time that you and I spoke, one of my strengths was actually blocking me from moving forward.
Yes.
And I'm trying to think. Oh, I'm trying to remember which one it was, but I wanted to be unique. Which strength is that?
Oh, significance. Yes. Significance.
Significance. Yes. Yes. I wasn't changing the world enough as I wanted to.
Exactly. Everything had to have like its uniqueness to it. And that's the great thing. Like, cause your strengths can be your barriers, right? Because there's such a huge part of your life that you don't even know it. So, you know, so it's taken me years to figure those out, to figure out my barriers. And there's times, and if anyone ever takes it and has a futuristic one, for me, if I don't see clearly enough on my futuristic one, I'm a mess, man. Like my focus is out of whack. I can't include anyone, you know, like it can kind of take you down, right? Like you said, with your significance. So, but yeah, for sure. Your activator and, strategic, definitely partner those two together and you're going to make stuff happen. So
Yes. Well, Amanda, thank you so much.
You're so welcome.
I can't thank you enough for sharing everything that you know with everybody of the Startup Circle and Sassy Girl community. I truly, truly appreciate you being part of this today.
Yeah, of course. And every Friday, just one last little plug. Every Friday, I write a blog, and a newsletter. And it's just about, you know, just little things in our lives that like for positive psychology reasons, like things that we just need to start doing, you know, little things to strengthen ourselves, to feel better about who we are and to not, you know, be in such a place of constant worry or stress or, you know, it's to use this stuff, like to really build up who you are, what you want to do, where you're heading, and really make some huge achievements on redefining what achievement looks like for you. So thanks for giving me the space. I really appreciate it.
You are welcome. And I will give everybody your website information, your email, and a link to your blog as well so that they can access that. So thank you so much, Amanda. Enjoy that sunny San Diego.
Oh, I will, for sure.